Good morning, and on Pentecost Sunday, welcome to this special service from Wade Street Church today. Wherever you are, and whoever you are, whether you're sitting dressed and attentive in your sitting room, or still in your pyjamas slumped across the bed, with a cup of coffee in your hand in the kitchen, or waiting for your partner to bring you breakfast in the conservatory. We've been producing these services like this each Sunday since the lockdown started, and it's been good to have people from far and wide looking in, so you are all welcome this morning. Now, over the past few years, we've been asked to be part of the Lichfield Blues and Jazz Festival weekend, which we've greatly enjoyed. So when it was announced that the festival itself was cancelled due to the COVID-19 situation, we thought we'd try and continue just this little bit of it. This service will be a mixture of what we usually do and a bit of other stuff. It's going to be either something for everyone or something to offend everyone. Not enough like church for some of you and too much like church for others. It'll be a couple of musical pieces, some songs that you can sing along with too, and we're accompanied by some of our usual musicians, but it's been difficult producing the same amount of music that we normally do, with recording parts from home and all that kind of thing. And we don't have any guest musicians this year either, unfortunately. So there isn't quite as much music as usual. But we hope that you'll enjoy it, though. If you've got children with you, there'll be some activities for them on the WSC Children's Ministry Facebook page. And if you're a regular member of the congregation, there's the usual virtual coffee on Zoom afterwards, I believe. Now, blues and jazz are very closely linked with spirituality and religion. The blues grew out of the songs of the slaves yearning for heaven, keeping up their spirits with praise to God, and fusing their theology with the folk music of the West and the rhythms and the harmonies of Africa. There have been many blues players with very clear Christian influence, Eric Bibb, Glenn Kaiser, Paul Jones, Eric Clapton. And the language and rhythms of the blues flow into jazz, again with many whose work has been influenced by the Christian faith. The work of Duke Ellington, Dave Brubeck, Johnny Dankworth, players such as Abe Laboriel, Alex Acuna and Ben Castle. So the skeleton for our worship today will be a piece by John Coltrane, the legendary sax player, groundbreaking performer, who messed about with rhythms and keys and chords and scales and everything else in a way that no one had really done before. He lived a troubled life, but he experienced a clear religious conversion which influenced everything else he ever did. There's an underlying spirituality in his work. Basically Christian, although it does wander off into other religious ideas, even, believe it or not, it's a church of John Coltrane in America where he is revered as a saint. But one of his greatest and probably best known works is called A Love Supreme. It's a long and difficult piece of music, but the final movement of it, called Psalm, is really a musical prayer. Coltrane wrote in words a long poetic prayer which he put on his music stand and then played it. You can hear, if you ever hear the music and see the words, you can hear the music following the words. We heard the opening of the piece as an intro to this service, but the whole thing is around 46 minutes long. So we're just going to use some phrases of that written prayer in our worship this morning, starting with these words. Seek him every day. In all ways, seek God every day. Let us sing all songs to God, to whom all praise is due. Praise God. And we're going to use some words from a biblical psalm to follow those words of Coltrane. The psalms are effectively very early blues and jazz stuff, I suppose. They're kind of songs of praise and of yearning. This is from a psalm of praise, from Psalm 57. And you can join in with me by saying the words in bold letters as a response. Praise the Lord. We will sing and make music with all our soul. Awake, harp and lyre. We will awaken the dawn. We will praise you, O Lord, among the nations. We will sing of your great love among the peoples. For great is your love, higher than the heavens. Your faithfulness reaches the skies. Be exalted, O God, above the heavens, and let your glory be over all the earth. And some more of Coltrane's words. He is gracious and merciful. Thank you, God. Glory to God. God is so alive. God is. God loves. It's often very difficult to express our praise in words. If you read all of the words of A Love Supreme, you can see that Coltrane struggled to put his prayer into words, which is why, in the end, he played it. And that's what this next song is really saying. Our limited human vocabulary is just not capable of truly expressing our thanks for God and for the beauty of his creation. And if you'd like to sing along with this arrangement by Abe Boucher, the words will be on the screen. You are beautiful beyond description.
Grasp your infinite wisdom. Who can fathom the depth of your love? You are beautiful beyond description. Majesty enthroned above. And I stand in awe of you. I stand in awe of you. Holy God, to whom all praise is due, I stand in awe of you. And I stand in awe of you. I stand in awe of you. Holy God, to whom all praise is due, I stand in awe of you. You are beautiful beyond description, too marvelous for words, too wonderful for comprehension, like nothing ever seen or heard. Who can grasp your infinite wisdom? Who can fathom the depth of your love? You are beautiful beyond description. Majesty enthroned above. And I stand in awe of you. Stand in awe of you.
Now, one of the things we've been doing as part of our online services each week is invite folk from the regular congregation to send us in photos or video clips or messages that are really reasons to be cheerful, to thank God for his goodness. It's a way of keeping in contact with each other and seeing what each other's doing. And we're just going to watch one or two of those at this point before we pray. And I'm just going to mention something that came in from Janet Cruz, who wanted to express her thanks and support to everyone this last week when the funeral of her uncle Alan took place. It went really well. The weather was fine. They had it outside in the churchyard. And she is really grateful to God and to the prayers and support of all the folk in the congregation.
So I want to say thank you to God for wisdom, strength and energy to homeschool two very energetic children with a lot of questions, whilst at the same time working really hard and long hours. I am a director of a care home company. We look after around 4,000 people across the UK, and I am just so thankful to our care workers. I'm really humbled by them and the lengths they have gone to continue to support the people we support over the last few weeks during this pandemic. I'm so grateful for the recognition of care workers through this crisis. It's known as the, it used to be known as the Cinderella profession, and I'm just so thankful that the media and more people recognise care and how hard care workers work. And I'm really humbled, and it's been an emotional few weeks in my job, but God's strength, love, mercy and grace has really carried us through. Amen to that.
Charlotte has finished her 26-mile scooter challenge.
Yay!
Thank you to anybody who supported her and sponsored her in this. She has raised £240
for Mersey Ship.
Woo!
Hi, I just wanted to thank everybody at Wade Street. I've got some fantastic news about Lichfield Christian Schools Work Trust. Back in February, the church meeting agreed to support the trust, and I submitted an application to the United Reformed Church Mission Fund and attended a meeting, a Zoom meeting, what fun, with them earlier this week. And they confirmed and approved the application for funding that we'd made. It was for £30,000 over 3 years. This will secure the future of the trust for that period of time. But what we do need is more volunteer mentors, and we also just need your support. I have no doubt that young people in our schools are going to need an awful lot of mental health support over the coming months. So thanks a lot, and keep in contact with me. Bye.
So as we've seen those little clips and heard those particular items to praise, keep them in your mind as I lead us in a prayer. And then we're going to say together the words of the Lord's Prayer. They'll be on the screen if you need them. Let's pray. Creator God, origin of all that is good and enjoyable, maker of art and music, poetry and pleasure, landscape and star-filled skies, we worship you this morning. May the wind of your Holy Spirit blow through us and around us as we come together in our separate locations, joining our praise and prayers with each other and with your people around the world and throughout time. We thank you for your love for us, expressed in your faithful provision for us, and your constant, if often unacknowledged, presence with us. Accept our gratitude and meet with us this morning, inspiring our praise and empowering our lives. We offer it all to you in the name of your Son and through the power of your Holy Spirit to bring you glory and honour. Amen. And we say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. And forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We also take a few moments each week just to mark any birthdays and celebrations that folk from the congregation will be enjoying this week. And if you're someone who's just watching in and you've got a celebration this week, well, we hope it goes well and you enjoy it. But just to mention a couple of birthdays, this very day today, Dave Badcock is celebrating his birthday. Happy birthday to him. On Tuesday, Dorothy Nichols is having a birthday, and Pat Cartmell's birthday is on Thursday.
We interrupt this service to bring you an additional announcement. Sadly, one of our regular worship contributors, Ollie Nichols, has failed completely in his duties as a father. He had one simple task to do, letting Jacob Productions know that it was his daughter's birthday this week before 5 p.m. on Thursday, so that it could be included in the birthday section of the service. And he was sadly lacking. To save face, this separate bulletin has been approved by the production team to ensure that everyone knows that Miriam Nichols is celebrating her 10th birthday tomorrow. And even though her father has let her down so badly, we trust that you are able to recover and have a fantastic birthday. As a small token to make up for all this tardiness, this particular birthday hedgehog will be posted through your door in the near future. Happy 10th birthday, Miriam. Ollie, you owe me. And now we return to normal service.
Yesterday, Ray and Kath Rowe celebrated their golden wedding anniversary, and next Saturday, Phil and Ray Beecher will be doing the same. So congratulations to Ray and Kath, and to Phil and Ray. Now, if you've been to any of these blues and jazz services in the past, you know there are a couple of things that we always seem to include. One is a hymn sung to the tune of that great old blues favourite, House of the Rising Sun. It's a great tune, and because of its meter, the rhythm of it, it fits a huge number of well-known hymns. So this morning, we're using some words that will be familiar to many, many people, written by an ex-slaver, John Newton, who had a dramatic conversion and eventually became a priest. And he played his own small part in the abolition of slavery. So if you'd like to join us, the words will be on the screen, and we'll sing Amazing Grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. T'was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the hour I first believed. And grace will lead me home. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we know there's days to sing God's praise. That when we first begun,
in John Coltrane's experience, it was vital that he discovered and accepted God's forgiveness. And it was crucial for him that he was able to ask for it again and again and again. And indeed, that's the case for all of us, something we do regularly as part of our worship. As John Coltrane wrote, "No matter what, it is God. He is gracious and merciful. It is most important that I know thee." So we come to God once again this morning to ask for his help as we pray. Let's pray. Gracious and merciful God, we thank you for your grace and for your willingness to forgive. We have to confess that we've messed things up again this week. We've sometimes made the wrong call when we've been offered choices. And you've offered us so much that sometimes we've chosen to ignore it or abuse it or to change it into something very different from what you've intended. And we know it's wrong because we've often felt that twinge of guilt or regret. Thank you that through your son Jesus and his death on the cross, you're somehow able to put that right. We don't necessarily understand it, but we accept it. And we pray that you'll help us not to make the same mistakes again. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. And whenever we come to God in sincerity like that, God always assures us of his forgiveness and redemption. As Coltrane says, he will remake. He always has and he always will. It is true. Blessed be his name. Thank you. We're going to hear a reading from the Bible now. Phil Beecher, who's already had a mention this morning due to his impending golden wedding, is going to read to us from the book of Acts, from chapter 17, where St. Paul is waiting in Athens for some friends to arrive. And he does a bit of sightseeing, which gets him rather worked up. And Phil's going to read Acts 17 from the Message translation.
The longer Paul waited in Athens for Silas and Timothy, the angrier he got. All those idols, the city was a junkyard of idols. He discussed it with the Jews and other like-minded people at their meeting place, and every day went out onto the streets and talked with anyone who happened along. He got to know some of the Epicurean and Stoic intellectuals pretty well through these conversations. Some of them dismissed him with sarcasm. What an airhead. But others, listening to him go on about Jesus and the resurrection, were intrigued. "That's a new slant on the gods," they said. "Tell us more." These people got together and asked him to make a public presentation over at the Areopagus, where things were a little quieter. They said, "This is a new one on us. We've never heard anything quite like it. Where did you come up with this anyway? Explain it so that we can understand." Downtown Athens was a great place for gossip. There were always people hanging around, natives and tourists alike, waiting for the latest titbit on most anything. So Paul took his stand in the open space at the Areopagus and laid it out for them. "It's plain to see that you Athenians take your religion seriously. When I arrived here the other day, I was fascinated with all the shrines I came across. And then I found one inscribed, 'To the God nobody knows.' I'm here to introduce you to this God so that you can worship intelligently, knowing who you're dealing with. The God who made the world and everything in it, this master of sky and land, doesn't live in custom-made shrines or need the human race to run errands for him as if he couldn't take care of himself. He makes the creatures don't make him. Starting from scratch, he made the entire human race and made the earth hospitable, with plenty of time and space for living so that we could seek after God and not just grope around in the dark, but actually find him. He doesn't play hide and seek with us. He's not remote, he's near. We live and move in him, can't get away from him. One of your poets said it well. We're the God created. Well, if we're the God created, it doesn't make a lot of sense to think we could hire a sculptor to chisel out a God of stone for us, does it? Now, God overlooks it as long as you don't know any better. But that time is past. The unknown is now known, and he's calling for a radical life change. He set a day when the entire human race will be judged and everything set right. And he's already appointed the judge, confirming him before everyone by raising him from the dead. At the phrase raising him from the dead, the listeners split. Some laughed at him and walked off making jokes. Others said, let's do this again. We want to hear more. But that was it for the day, and Paul left.
Before we reflect on that story, here's another piece of music to listen to. The blues and later jazz fed into a lot of gospel music in the late 19th, early 20th century. And out of that came the revival hymns that were so popular in the tent meetings and revivalist rallies. Fanny Crosby was one of the most prolific writers of such hymns, and many of them were set to music by a lady called Phoebe Knapp. They're good old foot-tapping tunes that lend themselves to all kinds of improvisation. And some of our musicians here are now going to play a version of Blessed Assurance, which follows on really from that last quotation from John Coltrane. So let's listen to Blessed Assurance.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, a purchase of God, born of the Spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, a perfect delight, visions of rapture that burst on my sight, an angel's descending, a bring from above, echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, and all is at rest. I am my Savior, I'm happy and blessed. I'm watching and waiting, and looking above, goodness, lost in his love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, I'm praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior. My song, I'm praising my Savior all the day long.
Now, as we've already said this morning, there's an underlying spirituality to a lot of jazz. And certainly the original blues were part of the slaves' attempt to express their yearning for God. But a great deal of that spirituality, even that of John Coltrane's music, was an expression of searching rather than a statement of discovery. People were saying, there's something out there, but we don't quite know what. Let's just hope he or she's listening. And many people today will acknowledge the existence of a God of some sort, particularly in a time of crisis such as the one we're going through at the moment. A recent study by the University of Copenhagen that we referred to last week, if you were watching, discovered that many more people have admitted to praying regularly since this pandemic began. There's been a very significant rise in the number of people accessing church services. People are aware in their own lives of something about God. They know maybe some stories from the Bible, even if they don't know exactly that that's where they come from. And there are some people who actually say they wish they could know God a bit better. Well, many centuries ago, St. Paul, as we've heard, found himself in Athens, and he had the opportunity to tell the people in the marketplace about the God who is behind creation, the hand that made us. Amongst all the statues and altars in the city, he'd spotted one that was dedicated to an unknown God. They were really hedging their bets, weren't they? And he felt he ought to give the Athenians some help in discovering the identity of the God they didn't know. He started off by directing their gaze at the world around them, the wonderful world, written about by Bob Teeler and George Weiss, and made famous in Louis Armstrong's 1967 recording. How do you think all this got here? Paul asks. The God you seem to be in the dark about, the God you're searching for, put all this together. It all somehow points to him. Why don't you look around you today? And why don't we? All that we can see here speaks of some kind of being, some creative force behind the world we see. And many, many people would acknowledge that, even many who would make no claim whatsoever to be Christians. But Paul went on to tell his listeners that this God isn't some kind of remote deity up beyond the skies, like their own mythical gods who only get involved in the world to start battles or seduce women. Or more recently, perhaps, like Terry Pratchett's Discworld gods who sit around in Dun Manifesting all day playing cards. Paul says, God doesn't play hide and seek with us. He's not remote, he's near. We live and move in him. We can't get away from that. And that God has gone to enormous lengths to help us to get to know him better. He actually came into our world and lived as a human being so he could identify with us. Another writer in the Bible says that that's one of the great strengths of the Christian God. He suffered and put up with the same problems that you and I have to face each day But he went well beyond that too. Jesus, God's son, the God-man, actually consented to take on himself the consequences of and the punishment for all the wrong things we do when he died on that cross just outside Jerusalem. And a couple of days later, he was brought back to life to demonstrate that there is hope for us as well. Hope that we too will move beyond this life, beyond death, to an eternal and unchanging relationship with God. There'll be many people watching this morning who do actually know this God, the God who is proclaimed by the very existence of creation, the God about whom we've sung in our songs. Whatever the process of its coming into being, we believe that this creation is all the work of God, a God who may be unknown to you as yet, but who longs to reach out to you. When Paul had finished speaking there in the marketplace, some people treated it as a huge joke and went off laughing about it. Some said, well, they wanted to hear a bit more, really. And some said they wanted to believe there and then. What's your response this morning? Are you going to risk laughing it off? Do you want to find out a little bit more? Do you, like Coltrane and others, want to keep on seeking? Are you reaching out for some kind of certainty, even just a sense of hope in this current crisis? Or do you want to say this morning that you want to believe it and receive from the God who made you and who loves you? Obviously, we're not going to force you into any one choice, but you've got to make a choice, even if it's only to walk away and say you want nothing to do with it. And think hard about that, because it's a great risk to ignore it. Think about it, in fact, as we listen to another song. This is a song written and performed for us by Bam Rushton, who's performed many times in and around Lichfield, part of the church here. And he's singing this together with the help of John King. It's called Falling Through Life.
Good morning, everyone. And it's great to be part of this virtual blues and jazz service. Hope you're going to enjoy this. And this is a song called Falling Through Life. It's about relying upon the grace of God in these uncertain times. And it's been recorded and produced, and he plays the drums as well, by John King. I wrote the song, and here it is. We've even got a crowd. We've got a crowd in for you as well, to make you feel, you know.
someone to pick me up, brush me down, and carry me away.
As we said earlier, the blues morphed into all kinds of other things, including gospel. And there are elements of both the yearning and the praising in most old gospel and revivalist hymns. I'm going to sing a good old standard now, which will lead us into our prayers this morning. We've sung this song at every blues and jazz festival service we've done, but this is a new arrangement. Especially for this morning's service by Hannah Tranchant, who's also produced the performance that we're about to use. If you want to join in, please do so. If you want to sit back and listen, that's fine. What a friend we have in Jesus.
Thank you.
John Coltrane was sure that God could help him cope in all kinds of situations and was a source of hope and optimism, even in times of sadness and stress. And he wrote in that Love Supreme, God is all. Help us to resolve our fears and weaknesses. In you, all things are possible. Thank you, God. God will wash away all our tears. He always has. He always will. And so we bring our prayers to God this morning. Let's pray. God of life, God of love, God of music and beauty, God of laughter and tears, help us, we pray, to cope with the things that make life difficult for us. The anxieties, the pressures, the uncertainties of what is going on around us. We have sung that we have a friend in Jesus. May we feel him holding our hand as we struggle in the darkness of this current crisis, hugging us to him as we try to cope with grief, boredom, or frustration, or try to make sense of disappointment. May we be assured that he is reaching out to those we love and on whose behalf we are afraid. Bring healing and security to them and to us, we pray, as we remember particularly in the silence those who are close to us with needs at the moment. And loving God, may we see glimpses of your hope in a world that can so often appear hopeless, helpless, and harassed. We offer our prayers in Jesus' name. Amen. Here's a very contemporary song written by the prolific worship leader Matt Redman. Takes up the theme of many of the Psalms and pulls together some of the things that we've already expressed in our songs this morning. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul. I worship your
sun.
Now, before some final words from Coltrane and a closing prayer, just one or two bits of information, mainly for the folk who worship with us regularly, but there'll be some stuff for other people as well. Please keep sending in your items for praise and thanks, as well as letting us know about any birthdays and anniversaries that we can mention. And don't forget, to all of you, if any of you or anyone you know needs any help, there are folk at the church who volunteered to step in and do whatever's needed. If you can't get out, or if you've got particular needs, or something happens, you need some support. You can talk, you can call me, your house group leader if you're part of the congregation, or there's some information on the screen at the end of this service. Or you can simply email volunteers@wadestreetchurch.co.uk. Once again this morning, if you're a regular worshipper with us, you can have a conversation over a cup of tea or coffee. You'll have to provide yourself, of course, via our virtual refreshments on Zoom. There should be a link on Facebook, or you may have had one by email even. And for those of you who are members of the church, there is a church meeting on Tuesday the 9th of June, which will take place on Zoom. So look out for details of how to join in that, please. All being well, we'll be back next Sunday with another YouTube service. Please let other people know about this. And if you know anyone who may have difficulty hooking into the internet, we can let them have a DVD or an audio CD of the service if you let us know. If you're interested in what goes on generally at Wade Street Church and you'd like to find out a bit more, there'll be some contact details on the screen at the end of this service. And finally, a big thank you to everyone who's been involved in this service, the musicians, the singers, the readers, James Cresswell and Colin Bridle, who produced it, Lichfield Arts, who originally asked us to take part. And thanks too to Glenn Marshall, the principal of Northern Baptist College, for pointing me towards a love supreme, though he doesn't know it. And of course, in the words with which John Coltrane finished A Love Supreme, above and beyond everything and everyone else, thank you, God. Elation, elegance, exaltation, all from God. Thank you, God. Amen. And our final blessing is from Walter Brueggemann's Prayers for a Privileged People. It links in with the idea of God's Holy Spirit, described as a wind, and reminds us that today is Pentecost Sunday. This is our final prayer. The news is that God's wind is blowing. It may be a breeze that cools and comforts. It may be a gust that summons you to notice. It may be the storm that blows you where you have never been before. Whatever the wind is in your life, pay attention to it. And the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit will abide with you always. Amen.
Waymaker, miracle worker. worship you. I worship you. You are here, healing every heart. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, mending every heart. I worship you. I worship you. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who. That is who you are. 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 That is who. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. In the times I am low, you are working. In my moments of joy, you are working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. In the times I am low, you are working. In my moments of joy, you are working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop. You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. That is who you are.